So this proof, we are going to do it in multiple steps. We just split it into 3-4 steps. That is easier to follow. And again, the proof goes along similar lines as we did in the weighted majority algorithm, that is expert prediction with expert advice. But in this case, we have to account for the case that I am dealing with the estimators, not the actual loss values. Okay. Our goal is to show Rn bar is less than or equals to k by 2, t equals to 1 to n, eta t plus ln k by. Okay. So, first thing, useful inequalities. First, if I am going to look into the expectation of LIT hat, okay. Notice that this LIT itself is a random quantity, right? Because the way it is defined, LIT is defined as what is this? So, IT is a random quantity. So, depending on its randomness, there is a induced randomness on this LIT. So, now this is a random, and if I am going to take expectation with that randomness, so this IT here is distributed according to PT, right? If I am going to take that, what is this quantity is? LIT, right? We said this is already an unbiased estimator, so this is going to be LIT. But now, if I look into this quantity, but now I treat this to be a random variable, I index with which I am going to take this expectation as, then let me treat this value. Now, what is this quantity? So, let us write down this. What is the meaning of this quantity? This is going to say that, so this I is a random variable. So, I is going to be drawn according to this distribution PT. So, I, that is why I am going to take summation over j equals to 1 to k, and then it is L j t and then P j t here, right. So, this is the meaning of this expectation here. If you are now going to plug back this quantity here, what is this? And this is still I t equals to j and PJT, right. I have just plugged back the value of this estimator here. So, what is this quantity? So, this indicator remains whenever IT equals to J, for all others it vanishes, but this IT is random quantity. So, then this quantity is going to be L of IT T. Wherever this guy is there, this term remains, everywhere it is going to be 0. Okay. So, with this let us proceed. So, this is we are going to call as first step. I am interested in bounding L I T T. See, in terms of the notation, I am slightly messing up. Notice that, like, what I am doing is, when I say LT, LT is a vector, and when I say LTI, this is the ith component of this vector. So sometime I am writing it as LIT. For example, here I write. So let's try to follow the same convention. Okay, I hope. Okay, let's take this. So here it is just like which component you are going to treat it as random variable, right? So here when you wrote this is you are fixing an I. For every I, this is a random variable, right? Now looking at the expectation of this. Now here, yes, this is a random variable, but you are looking at the further taking expectation with respect to the I here. So that is why whatever you got here, it itself still a random variable, right? I mean, you see this, why this is useful when I write the further steps. Okay, so let's take fix one particular action k. This is the total loss you are going to incur if you are going to deal with kth action, all the if you are going to play the kth action. And this is the total loss you are going to incur if you are going to play as per your algorithm IT. Algorithm that says to play IT in round T. Now using this notation, whatever I have here, what I can write. This is going to be minus, and what is this? This quantity I am going to write it as this. Sorry, this should be k here. It is fine. I have written this loss difference in these two cumulative loss in terms of their expected values that are induced by the randomness of your algorithm. Okay. Now we are going to write this quantity over here. In this following fashion. Okay, let me write it first and we'll discuss. Okay, so I did some strange manipulation here. Okay, first notice that suppose you for time being just forget this part. Okay, if you just forget this part, I am basically this and this negate, right? If you do this. Now let's take this part. Notice that this part is an expectation here. So if you are going to take exponential inside, then this quantity is an already constant because this is already taken to be expectation. So this when you take this exponential on this, this is like a log of a constant, then it log of exponential simply becomes this quantity, which is on the left hand side. Okay, and this is just to go and see that this part, if you just ignore, because this is going to get nullified with, if you just focus on this part, it is nothing but log of exponential expectation of exponential of this quantity, but this exponential of this quantity is constant because there is already taken expected value. So this is simply going to be log of expectation of this quantity, because this expectation will not matter because it's already a constant. So log of exponential will nullify, this log will nullify this exponential. What we will end up with, simply minus eta times this quantity, this eta is eta will cancel and you will just end up with this quantity. So why we did this? Why do we did this circus? The circus is to make sure that we express them in terms of their moment generating functions. You know moment generating functions, okay, or characteristic functions. So it is basically log of expectation of exponential of that random variable. Okay. Here basically I have written this LTI to be the moment basically this first part is the moment generating function of this quantity LTI tilde. This is a random guy, right? This is basically the moment generating function of that. And now what is this quantity? This is nothing but the mean. Even though I written k here, but this is just an index, but this is nothing but the mean of this quantity. So I basically subtracting mean from it and then looking at its moment generating function. Okay. So this, we have expressed this quantity in terms of its moment generating function. Now we will see that this moment generating function is easier to handle, to bound. Okay. Okay. Now what we will do? We are going to handle each of these parts separately. So let me call this as 1 and let me call this as 2. Now we are going to bound. So the second step is to bound 1. Okay, what is this quantity? Log of we always love to write the things in exponential form because we get very tight bounds when you write them in exponential. If you remember, like when we wrote weighted majority algorithm, we had a tight upper and lower bounds on e to the power minus x, right? So on e to the power minus x, we had this nice bounds. What was that? 1 minus x plus x square. And also we had a lower bound 1 minus x. We will use similar things here also. Okay, let me see what is this quantity. So this one I am going to write it as and this quantity, so the first term into the second term, this is going to be plus eta t, this term here eta t times
I'm only going to look into that expectation of k times dt ltk.
I just expanded this. Now sum, okay. So this is the same argument. Yes. So this is the same argument as I used earlier, right? Like this is like a constant already because expectation is taken. So log of exponential will nullify and it will just give you this much. Okay, now let's try to see how to apply this bounds here. This is a log quantity, right? So there is one more bound I am going to look. Log of x is upper bounded by x minus 1. Is this true always for let's say as x positive? Right, this should always hold. Now let us apply that logic here. So if I am going to apply, what is this is going to be exp. So I am going to treat this entire thing as log. So this is going to be expectation of I theta e exp. And minus 1 plus 30 this correct. So now I am going to pull this expectation outside from both the terms. It is going to be exp minus eta t lti minus 1 plus l. Is this correct? I am just manipulating things here. Now I am going to go and appeal to this quantity here. So what I will do? There is an eta t also here, right? I am going to treat eta t lti as my x. And now this is e to the power minus x minus 1 plus x. So e to the power minus x, if I am going to take minus 1 here and plus 1, this is has to be upper bounded by x square by 2. So this quantity will be upper bounded by eta t square lti square by 2. Okay. So it is fine. Now what I am going to do, anyway eta t square by 2 is these are constant, I will pull it out and now I am going to look at expectation of this. It is a tilde, it is a hat, right? So what is this expectation? Let us compute this expectation. This expectation is nothing but over j lt hat j pti ptj. This is the definition of this expectation. And now if I am going to replace this quantity by estimator by this definition, this is ltj indicator it equals to j divided by ptj, this quantity whole square divided by ptj. So doing some manipulation, maybe we can just skip around, go fast now. So this quantity is going to give me what? Only this is going to remain only for that it, everywhere else it is going to cancel and it is going to give me 1 l I t square divided by p t I t. Is this fine? Okay, I do not know if I mentioned that. We will assume that these losses are always in the interval between 0 1. Okay, so if we are going to make that assumption, this guy is going to be 2 p t I t because this l t I t square is upper bounded by 1. So fine, what we will actually end up with is, if I am going to substitute this quantity here, this guy is eta t square by 2 times 1 upon ptit. Okay, so this is the second step. What is my third step? Third step is to deal with this guy here. So let's take one upon eta t . So by the way, the way this proof goes, everything looks like what is happening, how these steps are all coming one after another, right? This manipulation. At least in the adversarial case, this looks like steps. I mean, somebody came up with this, but like these are like standard steps. This way manipulation will, some or the other way of manipulating things in this fashion will end up giving you the bounds that you are looking for. See, like we are ended up with a regret bound which are like of order square root n, right? That means it is, this algorithm is making things learnable, right? Because if I let n go to infinity, I am learning. That means I am doing as good as my benchmark per round if I am allowed large number of rounds. But see, what you are learning, you are trying to learn something about which you are clueless. These losses are generated in an arbitrary fashion. You do not know anything about that, right? You are not making any assumption. The only assumption is that I made it like they are in the interval 0, 1, but that can also be relaxed by normalizing. So you are dealing with a very general scenario. Coming up with is a, what is the right intuition to prove, give this process hard, but whatever the way, based on this exponential weights based algorithm has developed, and it looks like they have some standard way to go about proving these steps. Even though I am doing lot of manipulation here, but by and large you see that these are kind of similar to what we earlier did it for the weighted majority algorithm. So it is good, like we know these steps, and if we can understand, I mean at least if we are conversant with how this proof has gone through, maybe in some other setup that we want to prove, we can play with these steps and able to come up with a bound. Okay, in that regard it is important that we know the proof steps for this, even though it is all math, but a priori it is not clear why it has to go in this fashion. Okay, but do follow with all the steps I am trying writing here, so that later if you want to prove for something else, maybe if you understand this already, maybe you can see where to tweak the proof to get bounds for your algorithm. Okay, now this one I am going to write it as, so what is this one, minus 1 by eta t, and what is this? This is expectation of I want to have k rounds exp times minus eta lti is tilde, and then p ti, right? This is the expected value. But now I am going to replace, I know what is pti. Now I am going to bring in how this pti is used in my algorithm. So for all the steps I have written, they are generic. There is nothing special about DXP algorithm. So now if I am going to use this PTI here, so what is PTI? It has been shown to be, I mean it has defined as EXP minus eta T L hat TI divided by summation of that quantity. Okay. So now if you are, now I am going to take this numerator. So this quantity, what is LTI hat? LTI hat was defined to be the cumulative sum till round T, right? Now if I am going to add this as well, okay, sorry. So this at PT, this is defined to be LT minus 1 till the previous round, not till that round. So if you are going to add this LTI hat to this quantity, it becomes L hat T. Is this correct? I have just manipulated this. Now I am going to just define this quantity to be phi of t minus 1 computed at t minus phi of okay, where I'm going to say define so, if I am going to define phi t of eta to be this quantity, then this ratio here, I could write it as phi t minus 1 of at computed at eta t and phi t computed at eta t. So, is this clear? Okay, fine. So, then maybe for the remaining steps, we will do it in the, because this completes my third step. There are just two more steps, we will just do it in the next class, okay? Fine.